Hello, welcome to Lunar Astro. Today's topic is something very special on how to use your Mahadasha Lord to predict various events. Because usually the time span of Mahadasha is so big that, you know, we don't even consider this particular Mahadasha, how it will be or at what particular time. We use Antardashas and Pratyantardashas to predict events. But in this particular video, we will learn how to use only Mahadasha Lord to predict particular time frame, what will happen at what particular time. And this works beautifully. I use it. The only thing is with this particular method, the calculation has to be done by hand. And I will show you, it's very easy. I mean, if you have a calculator, you can do it very quickly. Now, the verse of this comes from the Chandra Kala Nadi. Also, if you have not subscribed on my website, please go ahead and do it. The link is below in the description section. The reason why I'm saying this is because very soon I'm going to start a series which is very special and which is on Shashtyamsha. I'm going to do videos on it, but before that, you can get some of the information on the website itself. From tomorrow onwards, I'm going to start writing on every single one of them in very detail because the research is almost complete. That's why I stopped taking consultations as well. Also, the course is starting from the 1st of May, from 5th of the May, first week of May, we are starting the course regarding Rashis and Grahas. Although it looks very simple because I couldn't find any better title than this, that Rashi, signs and planets, that's it. Because I think there's so much to cover within the science as well, because the current batch which I'm teaching, and you must have seen some of the videos of it, there's so much to cover within one sign. So much of the qualities of sign and to use it in prediction. So you're more than welcome to join. The course is also available. Now let us come to the verse of Chandra Kala Nadi. Let me share the PowerPoint. Okay, this is the one, Chandra Kala Nadi. Predict only using Mahadasha. The verse number 341 states, if the sun is in seventh house, in the middle of the Dasha, will bring royal honors to the native's father. In addition, native will be busy in his marriage activities. This is what the shloka is. Now, if you see before this 342 and 340, there's nothing regarding the dasha, what has been mentioned. Only in the verse 341, this line has been mentioned. And if you see what Maharshi Parashar or, and if you see what is actually meant here is, first of all, the Dasha Lagna has been used. So example, if somebody has a sun in 7th house during the mid of the Dashas, the sun will progress to the 7th house. And if you use Dasha as a sun as an ascendant now, because as a Dasha Lagna, the 7th house will get activated and native will get married. At the same time, the position of the sun is also been considered because when the seventh house from the sun will get active, it will be fifth to the father. And fifth is because that's a sun, so it's a royal honors. And fifth is your man, pratishtha position. That will come to the father due to the government. Now using this only verse only, we will use, we will see a couple of the example charts. We'll see how it has been interpreted. Because I've used it several times and the results are there. I request you all to please use it. It means progression has been used and during the mid of the Sandasha when sun will be 7 to the original position, activating 7th house from the natal position from the dasha, from the sun itself, the native will get married. Also, sun is placed 11 to the 9th. This also shows the father will get royal honors from the government. Both Dasha Lagna and the natal position has been considered in the same shloka. Also, now let's see the Mahadasha periods. See, Ketu stays in a sign, Ketu Dasha is Mahadasha is of 7 years, Ketu stays in a sign of for 7 months. So whatever is the Mahadasha period, so Venus is 20 months, 20 years of Mahadasha, 20 months in a sign. 6 years of Mahadasha, 6 years in a sign. Similarly, days per degree will be also 7. It is usually 7.04 7 20.06, something like this comes up. But for the sake of clarity, you can use this as a round figure. Mercury has been written wrong here in the PowerPoint. Just a second. Okay, now the Mercury has been corrected. Mercury is 17 years, 17 days, 17 months in a sign. 17 years Mahadasha, 17 days per degree. You can calculate. So when you know all this, it will be very easy to calculate. Now the rule is for retrograde planets, Rahu and Ketu, and the retrograde planets, if you're running the Dasha of a retrograde planet, Mahadasha of a retrograde planet, that planet will always go in opposite direction. But if you see, if you're considering 20 months in a sign, suppose somebody is in the Venus Mahadasha and it has 20 months in a sign, so that will be very big, you know, to narrow down the event. What you can do and what actually we all should do, that to narrow down the time period, you should divide 20 months into the nine sign, into nine parts. So one for each in a bunch. So it will be around almost 66 days. Almost 66 days in a one bunch. So it will be narrowed down. For the biggest Mahadasha, it will be narrowed down to 2 months. That in this particular 2 months, this particular event will happen. Now we'll look at some of the example charts. Okay, this is example number one. This is of American President Bill Clinton. And this, we are considering the Dasha of Jupiter in this particular example. Dasha of Jupiter started on 21/07/1987. And as Jupiter was exactly on the starting degrees, I have taken 16 months as it is. Started from sign of Libra from 21/07/1987, 1 month, 1 year, 4 months. The Jupiter stayed in sign of Libra till 21 November 1988. Then it moved to Scorpio, Sagittarius, Capricorn, and you see this is a very easy calculation. You can keep doing it. Now you see Dasha of Jupiter was important because Dispositor is sitting in ascendant. Jupiter progression to sign of Capricorn. Now if you see, if you consider Dasha Lagan, Jupiter as a Lagna now, because it's a Dasha Lagan. The movement of Jupiter into sign of Capricorn, it's a Libra ascendant, Saturn is a Yoga Karaka. It moved to the fourth house, fourth lord goes into seventh, into 10th house from here, if you consider Jupiter as a Lagna. This was the time period when Bill Clinton became the president. When Jupiter entered Pisces, which is the seventh house of the natal chart, he started an affair with our secretary, Monica. Entered Pisces in 1995, by the end of 1995, he started an affair with Monica Lewinsky, his secretary. And from 1995 to 1997, till Jupiter was in Aries, the affair was continuing. But as soon as Jupiter moved to Taurus in 1998, everything came in limelight. Now, during this particular time period, you can see that this is the 8th house as compared to the Jupiter. 8th lord goes in 12th from Jupiter, debilitated with the 8th house, 8th lord Mars. This was not a very good time period for Bill Clinton. And you can see in this particular time period only, he faced a maximum amount of problem. That was a very prominent damage to his career. Okay, let's look at another example. This is chart of Lord Osho Rajneesh. As soon as his Jupiter Dasha started, and see all, everything, most of the planets are in 6-8 combination to Jupiter in this chart. As soon as the Jupiter Dasha started, he started having problem with government over tax evasion. So there was a case, 6th house got active from Jupiter now. All the problem, Jupiter is a karaka for tax. Or everything related to Jupiter, the tax with the government was a problem. So what he did, as soon as Jupiter moved to Gemini, He moved to US. Third house is sign for move to move. At the same time, the Lord was also in the seventh house from itself. And seventh house is for foreign lands. He moved to USA. There also problem with the land deal began with the government. Again, the problem was there. Notice all dispositors from Jupiter are in 6-8. Also, Rahu is in 5th Jupiter here. The moment Jupiter entered Pisces from 1984 to 1986, this was a major time period when his students were accused of war crime, of mass food poisoning attacks, and you know, this is the same line of copy from Wikipedia. Students were accused of mass food poisoning in the wake of serious crimes by his followers, including a mass food poisoning attack with bacteria and aborted assassination plot to murder US attorney. All these things happened. Why? Because Jupiter had Rahu in fifth to it, that the moment Jupiter activated it, make Jupiter as a Dasha Lagna. And then you will see why it all happened in this particular Jupiter time period. From 1984 to 1986, this was a time period. So you see how beautifully the Dasha worked, this particular technique worked. I've not used Navansh in this particular cases. You can go ahead and do it. You'll find it absolutely working. Because when I look at the, when I check the events from the Dasha, I always use this technique as well. Because this gives you another insight what is happening with the Mahadasha. So if suppose somebody has a debilitated planet, during the mid of this Dasha, that planet will give the results of exalted planet. At the same time, somebody has an exalted planet during the mid of the Dasha, the planet will get debilitated. This is how the Dasha progression works. Let's look at a couple of more charts. And started, let's look at this chart. Dasha of Saturn started. Saturn progression continued. The moment Saturn progressed to his own house in seventh house, because Saturn is also the Dasha Lagna, Saturn is also the Mahadasha. Saturn touched Ketu. What happened? The wife, because they were living in a foreign land, wife decided that she needed to go back to home, to India, for some reason. And the guy also lost the job during that time period. So they said, okay, let's go. Let me send my wife and kid to back to home. So there was a separation from wife. Not a problem. The moment Saturn entered Aries, see the dispositor also goes in 12th house, debilitated. What happened? The guy came back to India. And during that time period, wife accused the native of false dowry case and all the other cases, took 70, 80 lakh rupees from him. You know, before even he arrived to India, because this guy is not an Indian citizen. This guy is a foreign citizen. So in the name of purchasing a flat, the wife took all the money. And this guy had to go jail, debilitated Mars in 12th house, had to go jail because of this reason. This is what has happened. I'm very sure when the Saturn will enter the 10th house, this particular person, so see this particular case works. It absolutely works. Okay, let's look at this chart as well. This chart, this native is, this is a chart of a female, 1987 born. Now you see in this particular chart, Dasha was of Jupiter. As soon as Jupiter entered the fourth house, if we can clearly see fourth lord in third, it means shows movement, and third lord is going in seventh of marriage. The native got married that particular year as soon as Jupiter touched moon in the progression, but as soon as the Jupiter touched the comes to the fourth house. But after a few years of marriage, when Jupiter came to the second house, what happened during this time period was, you can also see this time period, you know, the second lord is also in the seventh house. It is with sixth lord. Now in this time period, there was a lot of trouble in the marriage, and the husband and wife, they both got separated during this time period only. So in this case also, it absolutely worked. To narrow down a time period, you can use the Navansh. Okay, I hope you understood the technique. It's a very simple technique to use. I will bring out more techniques from Chandra Kala Nadi like this. And please practice it. Please leave the share, feedback, comment, subscribe the channel. Also follow the blog as well, so that we can interact with each other. I hope to see you next time. Thank you.